Good morning students, welcome back to today's class. The last class we saw about the importance of a hydrosphere. The hydrosphere, it means, what is the meaning of hydrosphere? It means the water. So 97% of water is called salt water and remaining 3% is called fresh water. Isn't it? So water is important for all the purpose. It is used for all living beings. I hope you all learned this lesson and you all completed the home test also. Are you completed? Yes. Okay. Today class we are going to see about lesson number 3, continents of the world. So continents of the world. So in the previous standard, fourth standard also, we saw this topic. I hope you already know the 7 continents names. Again I am repeating in this lesson. So totally 7 continents in our earth. So what are the 7 continents? It is called Asia, Africa, North America, Antarctica, South America, Australia and Europe. So these are the 7 continents present in our world. So today class we are going to see about each day we are seeing different continent. Today class we are going to see about the first continent. It is our continent. So which is our continent? Can you say? Yes. So which is our continent? The Asia is called our continent. So Asia is called world largest continent in size and populations. The size also very large, and the most of the population also we can see in our continent. And so two most populous countries present, lot of countries are present in this continent, especially the two most populous populous countries. One China and the another one is called in our country India, present in Asia continent. And Mount Everest and the Himalayas also located in our continent. And other countries, so other countries also, some other countries located in Asia continent like Japan, Singapore, Malaysia, Saudi Arabia, Sri Lanka and Nepal, Pakistan and Maldives, Philippines and Afghanistan, Thailand and Indonesia. And these are the different countries present in our present in the part of Asia. Okay, so in the I hope you all learn this Asia continent and separate. So in this Asia, in the Asia continent, so which country we are all living? So Indian country, we are all called Indian people, Indian citizen. So India is called unity and the diversity. So unity in diversity. So it means why we called unity in diversity. Diversity because a lot of different religion and languages, cultures, people living the language different, culture may be different, religion may be different, but we all live together in our country. And India has 29 states and 9 Indian territories. And which is our capital place? So New Delhi is called capital of India, and India has several historical monuments. Monuments means that place it's remembering one person's life histories and the importance of that period, especially the king's period. The lot of monuments they were built, and one of monument, greatest monument present in our Indian country, what is it, Taj Mahal is one of a monument, and it is located in the Agra. It's located in Agra and the river bank of Yamuna, and this building fully constructed with the white marbles. It is fully constructed with the white marbles, and the most beautiful monuments in our country, and it is called Seven Wonders of the World. So the Taj Mahal is called Seven Wonders of the World. ஏழு அதிசயத்தில் ஒன்று அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறாங்க. And not only the Taj Mahal, the other historical monuments also present in our Indian country, like India Gate, it's located in India, and Sanjay Stupa, it's located in Bhopal, and Gateway of India, it's in Mumbai, and St. George Fort, and Gangaikonda Cholapuram, these are the places located in Tamil Nadu. So these are the called monuments in our Indian country. So dear students, so learn this topic today. Thank you.